I was born in 1972, and when I was 5 years old in 1977, there was no good reason to be inside. So the only thing fun to do was really to go out in the woods with other friends in the neighborhood. But by 1982, when I was 10 years old, there was a lot of tempting reasons to be inside. There was cable TV, there was video games, there was MTV and HBO, there was Apple computers.
I took 45 9-year-olds outside, and we walked under oak trees, and they said, "I'm scared." And we dug up earthworms, and they said, "Will they bite? Are they poisonous?"
There have been young people who are in their teens and 20s and 30s who have said that, you know, "I never saw the stars."
I really do believe we're at a critical tipping point regarding the health of our nation. One example of that is the childhood obesity epidemic that's continuing to increase. A few years ago, we heard that this generation of kids might be the first generation to live shorter lives than their parents. And now we're seeing the U.S. life expectancy actually has decreased 2 years in a row. That's never occurred ever in the history of our nation.
Richard documented just how bad things had become and the direction of where things were going. He coined the phrase nature deficit disorder, and by doing that, he gave us something to rally around, gave us something to understand there is a real problem here that we have to address.
What I'm excited about is that I have seen the movement that he's been a part of grow and grow and grow and grow. And all anybody has to do is go on his website.
When Last Child in the Woods came out in 2004, 2005, there was pretty limited literature on what the benefits were. So there was this kind of understanding that being in nature had positive benefits for children. And the book Last Child in the Woods and the subsequent forming of the Children in Nature Network, that became the emphasis, was providing that information, providing that literature, doing that research, making a library that's accessible to people. And so now it's really easy for someone like me or one of my colleagues to go online and find the data.
The website, in fact, became a source of research, resources, and it was open and free to anybody who wanted to go online and get it.
Well, I think many times data and science raises the level of awareness and to some degree credibility, but stories are what makes it stick. And I think that's the gift that Rich has. He can take the data and he can turn it into a story and be something that can drive passion and then ultimately drive change.
Rich is the first person who really reached beyond the choir. He was able to take people from very, very different backgrounds and reach down to a shared experience. And he put in that shared experience a shared meaning. He reached into something that was true, a universal truth.
And that's just what he did. He told the truth, and everybody else said, "We've got to do something."
And that gave the places like the Botanic Garden a great role to play in helping the next generation regain that connection with the natural world. Every year, the Botanic Garden recognizes an outstanding individual to give the Pritzlaff Conservation Award. This year, we diverged from giving this to a scientist and instead said, what is the single most important contribution that someone has made to the field of conservation? We think it's the next generation of conservationists, and we think that Richard Louv is the right one to receive the Pritzlaff Conservation Award.